மந்தமாகவில்லை இடம் பலம் திரும்பினார் அவரறிவார் கலங்கினார் பாதை
He is fisherman. My mother's Lily. She's housewife. My native is Inayam. I think many of you know that place, Inayam Puthandarai. My place is Inayam, near to Puthandarai. I studied BCom in Holy Cross College. My mom is here, Rajam and Immaculate ma'am. I was in prayer cell when I was studying Holy Cross College. Then after my study BCom, I joined in MBA in Satya Bhama University. I studied in Tamil medium only. I don't know anything in English. But I used to pray to God, God give your Holy Spirit. I used to pray to all days because I joined in MBA in Satya Bhama University. Many girls came from many other places. There are we are 20 people from Tamil Nadu, another 40 people from North India. So I should talk in English. So I didn't learn anything in English, but I learned. I used to pray to God. God gave me a Holy Spirit because Moses don't know anything. Moses don't know anything, but he asked. He prayed. Jesus. He prayed God. So he got the Spirit to guide people, Israel people. So that I prayed to God. I used to tell Jeremiah 1:10. As per Jeremiah 1:10, God gave me a strength, gave me a Holy Spirit, so I will I can able to speak in English like that. I pray every day. I used to pray when I was studying MBA. So I passed in 72% marks in MBA. Then 6 months I didn't get any job. Many people talk to my parents. You send your daughter in Chennai, but she finished MBA. Now after 6 months itself, she didn't get any job like that. So I just after finishing my MBA, I searched in Google finance vacancies. So I applied in Union Bank of India. So 40,000 people applied in Union Bank of India for a direct manager. I have no experience because just I finished MBA, then I applied in Union Bank of India. So I don't have I don't know anything about banking. But when I was in at the age of 7, when I was third standard, my father, he's fisherman. He don't know. He's illiterate. In Inayam, one bank is there, SBT, State Bank of Tiruvangur. So he know only that bank. He don't know anything about engineering or doctorate, anything about that. So he used to tell, you should become bank manager, because he don't know only about that SBT. He used to tell, when I was at the age of 7 itself, he used to tell, you should become bank manager. So from third standard itself, if anyone asked me what you are going to become, like that, if anyone asked me, I used to tell, I want to become bank manager, like that. But I don't know anything about bank manager. I don't know anything about bank job. So I used to tell third standard itself, I used to tell, I want to become bank manager, like that. So I studied 12th mass biology, but after that I applied in Holy Cross College zoology department, but I got zoology department, but the last day the career changed. I took BCom, but I don't know how it's changed. It's miracle. So after that I finished MBA, then I applied UBA Union Bank of India job. So I went to they shortlisted my resume from 40,000 to 682. They shortlisted 682 candidates from 40,000 people, sir. So they called me to interview in Bombay Nariman Point, Shivaji Nagar. We have one central office there, one building. So the panel interview conducted. When I went there, I saw many people came from SBI, State Bank of India probationary officers. They finished five years their experience. So they have 5 years experience. So many people came from Kerala. I saw many people having experience. Just now myself is just I finished MBA, then I came here for interview. So what, Lord, you are, but you bring me here. so you should give job like that. I ordered to God because he is my father now. So he brought me to Bombay. So I came here from Kanyakumari to Bombay. So but I don't have any experience, but you brought me here, so you should give this job for me. Like that I ordered to God. So I that time many people, I saw many people preparing for interview. They in their hand I saw many clippings, many magazines about banking like that. I don't have anything. So I pray to God. I pray 1,000 praises. Yeah, and in that interview hall, waiting hall. Then I went to panel interview. My three people were sitting there. They asked many questions. They asked but I didn't apply in physical handicapped quota because I have vision. If God, I have a vision to become a bank manager, definitely God will give because my desire is to become bank manager. God also knows my desire because the Bible said if you see seek your happiness in the Lord, he will give you heart's desire. So I won't feel about my disability. God will give anything. I have the vision. God will give anything. I'm seeking the happiness in the Lord, so definitely he will give my heart's desire. So I have the confidence definitely in this interview definitely God will give bank manager job like that. They after finishing that interview, the people didn't tell that you are selected anything, nothing he tell they tell. So I waited for 1 month. The result didn't come. Then after February 20th, 2010, my interview is over. After then, after 1 or 2 months, May 29th, my results came. One call received from Bombay. They told, what is your date of birth? I told, 4686. So they told, you are selected as a direct manager. But before that result came, I was waited for 3 months. So many people, my relative is also, they told, your dad is only fisherman. You don't have any influences. This is the central government job, then direct manager. So many will get job by, they will give money. Big money, then they will get the job by influences like that. They told, but your father's only fisherman. He don't know anything. He don't know any MLA. He don't know MP like that. But my myself and my mom told, in this world, people will get by influences by giving money to money to bank by getting job by influences from MLA MP. My Jesus is great. So I am having the great man of in this world. That is my Jesus. So definitely I don't have dependent on any MLA MP, but I have the great leader in my life. I have the great person in my life. That is my Jesus. So definitely I will get job like that. I replied for that people who said you will not get jobs like that. So after getting results, interview results, I joined in the bank. I was before 2 years, at the age of 24, I saw all clericals and accountants all are above 40 years. But now I am just 24 years old. God brought me into that place as a direct manager for every people's. So I thank God because all are 40s, all are 40s except me. All accountants, all assistant managers, all clericals are above 40s age, above 40s. But I am the only child because I am the only just 24 years old. But you gave me the direct manager post. All peoples are above 40s. So how can I improve myself? I don't know anything about job like that. But I attended many training programs because after many training programs bank will give after from service also many training used to give bank many trainings given by the bank. So I attended 5 trainings. I got best participant in 5 trainings also. Now I am as a direct manager in Vadasiri. Before 6 months I was working in Tirunelveli. Then now March senior manager promotion is coming. So definitely I will become a senior manager in this March also. So all credit goes to my Jesus only. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
I want to ask you, when did you suffer from this polio?
When I was 8 month baby.
When you were 8 month baby.
Yeah.
So I want to ask you, in your childhood days,
yeah,
you would see all the other children running around and playing.
Yeah.
What was your effect in your heart?
Nothing, because I studied in St. Charles Com Convent, the Missionary Sisters of the Incarnation. They used to tell us Sister Alphonse's history. They used to tell many saints history. So I won't think this is one disability. I won't think from my childhood.
Okay. So in other words, even though it was something on the negative side,
yeah,
you did not focus on the negative side, but you began to rejoice with whatever God had given you.
Yes.
You began to strengthen yourself.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, if you were not comparing yourself with others.
Yes.
Is it right?
Yeah, I will not compare.
See, one of the most powerful tools that the devil uses to get us in depression is comparison. When you compare yourself with somebody else, you are insulting God. You know, the God's greatest glory is now that this baby who is having a problem in her legs, having the negative things in her life, but yet focusing on God, is able to achieve what a person has not been able to achieve at her age, being at 24 a manager in the bank. My friend, the devil always wants you to focus on your weaknesses. And God says, don't focus on your weaknesses, but focus on your strength and develop your strength. Your strength, when you begin to develop your gifts, your talents and the good things that God has given you, and you begin to strengthen that area, your weakness looks nothing in comparison to what God wants to do in your life.
Yes.
Is it true?
Yeah, I forgot to tell one thing. When I was...
Just keep the mic a little far.
Yes, okay. When I was attended that interview, panel interview in Bombay, in resume I noted I am a singer, I composed 17 songs like that I noted. Then I got many best speeches of the university for 2 years, 2008 and 2000, like that. Many things I noted in that resume. So they asked to perform. You speak something like that, they told. I spoke that time. Then you sing one song from your composing songs. So I sang also. Then after that they asked, are you fan of A.R. Rahman? Like that they asked.
Who?
A.R. Rahman.
A.R. Rahman.
Yeah. That time I told, no, I'm not anybody's fan. I'm the fan of myself. Like that I told. Then they asked me, you are having this disability. If you are appointed in bank, you should have transfer for every 3 years. How you can manage? Like that they asked. Because if you are joined in bank, you should have inspection to customers. You should have go to customer's place. Then how you can manage? But at that time I replied, you don't see my disability. I can do anything by the power that God gives in me.
Praise God. Praise God. Say that again. I like that.
You don't see my disability. I can do everything by the power that Christ gives in me.
That is in Philippians chapter 4:13. Please write down if you want. Philippians 4:13. I can do
anything.
All things. I can do
all things
by through the power. Jesus Christ who empowers me from within. Now, I want to ask you another question.
Yes.
When they were taking an interview, every answer that you were giving, you were giving from the Bible.
Not from the Bible, because 7 questions they asked from banking.
They asked from banking. Any personal question that they asked you, for example, you are disabled and all those things, and you gave the answer from the Word of God.
Yes.
And that is what gave you the victory.
Yes.
Praise God. So in our everyday life, you got to use the Word of God in our communication, in our day-to-day life, and this Word of God will give you the victory in every day of your life. Praise God. Was this journey easy? You had to spend a lot of hours studying?
Yeah, I have spent a lot of hours
studying. Because now when I'm listening to you speaking in English, and you said all your life you have been in Tamil school.
Yeah. Yes.
And English was very difficult language. You had to actually study and to do your MBA and your graduation, you had to take English as the first language.
Yes.
And it was difficult.
Yes.
So you put a lot of labor.
Yeah. Yes.
And after all that labor comes the victory.
Yes.
But haven't you seen people saying, I don't need to put labor, I need to only pray and God will do it for me. Will it happen?
No, it will not happen, because we have to work for ourselves, then God will give victory.
Praise God. My friends, here is a sister who has labored, spent hours and hours, might be spent sleepless nights studying for an exam. And what she planted at that time, she's reaping the harvest today. What did we learn? The secret of your future is hidden in your daily routine. In the morning when I met her, she said something to me. There were 5 of the other girls who are from English medium.
Yeah, English.
Just share with them.
When I was joining BCom, actually I am from Tamil medium now. So 5 girls from English medium, they will not study. But we 2 girls were studying English. We gave more effort to study English. So we 2 only passed in first class in English medium. But that 5 girls, some of they failed in some of the 1 or 2 areas they got. Then they got only second class marks.
Okay, now here is a young girl saying English was a difficult language because that was not a first language. She had friends in college who came from English medium, and especially for the subject English, they kept saying, this is a English, I've come from English medium, I've got no problem. But what happened? They took it for granted, did not labor, and they failed in the exams. What do you do on a daily basis decides your future. English was difficult and they made English their first subject to master it. It must have been so uncomfortable, it must have been so painful to study something that is so difficult. But yet, they labored, and what did they do? They mastered that language. What you don't master today will master you tomorrow. Write on. What you don't master today will master you tomorrow. What you don't master today will master you tomorrow. My friend, if you allow the sin to rule over your life and you don't master it, that sin will master you and make you a slave. If you are attracted to the Word of God, this Word of God will master you and rule over your life and guide you and take care of you. You know, for me, the greatest joy is when I saw her, is the labor that she put in. So many people must have, there are so many people who are handicapped. There are so many people who got weaknesses, and all the time they will be focusing on their weaknesses. If at all you get time, when you give them a DVD of this, see that you put a DVD of Nick, a man without limbs. Anybody has seen that? A man without limbs. This man is born without hands and without feet. Can he have any future? I want to ask you, my friends, can he have any future? He begins to pray to God and he says, why am I born this way? Lord, why have you not given me hands and feet? Why am I not like the others? And he's praying, Lord, let my hands grow, let my legs grow. But his hands and legs did not grow. He was depressed. And then he began to read in the Bible and he found in Jeremiah, God saying to Jeremiah, it is I who formed you. It is I who placed you in your mother's womb. It is I who created you. It is I who gave you the name. And it is I who have a purpose in your life. And he began to ask God, God, what is my purpose in life? I have no hands, I've got no feet. What can I do? And then he said to God, I do not understand what is your purpose, but now I will study your word day and night. Nick began to educate himself. He began to get different doctrines. He began to get different masters. And Nick began to give seminars after seminars. He began to go around and preach the word of God. In no time, people who were stressed came to his seminars and he said, you got hands, you got feet, but you are stressed out. I don't have hands, I don't have feet, but I am filled with peace and joy. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. And Nick began to go and share the gospel everywhere. In no time, people came to help him. Today, Nick is looking after more than 1,000 children who are just like him. He's feeding them, he's looking after them, and he's teaching them the word of God. This Nick recently got married and now he has got a child as well. Now, can a child who has got no hands, no feet, have a future in this world? How did he get his future? He got his future by getting into the word. Nick began to say, the very weakness of mine has become my strength. People come to listen to my seminar, first of all, to see how is this person who have got no hands and no legs live in this world. Nick has got no hands, no legs. But what little he has got, he combs his hair, he does everything with his mouth. He swims, he drives a car, he does everything. He says, you'd use your hands, I use some other part of my body, but I can do exactly what you do. He uses a computer, he operates everything. He types everything he does. How much are we complaining and grumbling in our life, even though God has given us everything? How much we fight with one another, even though God has given us everything? Is it right? Come on, is it right? So what is your answer? Are you going to praise God and thank God? Come on, here is our sister. For me, when she said, I'm 24, and at the age of 24, she's a bank manager, I said, people at 40 and 45 don't even reach that position. But let me tell you, before she could reach here, there was a lot of labor that was put. That same God is saying to you, I have got plans to make you a priest, anointed priest, a priest who will be preaching the word of God with the demonstrative power, a priest who will be reaching out to the poor, a priest who will heal the brokenhearted, a priest who will set the oppressed go free. Come on, God has got this plan. But for you to reach that position, Are you ready to put that extra labor? If you wouldn't have put that extra labor, could you get 72?
No.
Come on, close your eyes and make a declaration. Make that commitment to God. Look at her. At the age of 7, her dad said, "Baby, I want you to be a manager." A father who is illiterate, a father who is a fisherman, but has a dream. Come on, her father had a dream that my baby should be a manager in the bank, and he is fishing there, catching fish and paying her fees so that she can get educated and she can go and study for an MBA. A man with a dream. Who are you? Do you have a dream? Do you have a vision? What did this baby do? At the age of 7, when a dad said, "Baby, I want you to be a manager," day and night she had only one dream. I want to be a bank manager. I want to be a bank manager. I want to be a bank manager. Do you remember in the morning what we learned? The mold. What was a mold? A bank manager. What did she do? She labored to finish that mold. Close your eyes, my friend, and make a mold for yourself now. If you don't have a dream, if you don't have a vision, now's the time to make a vision and a dream. Here is a person who has given you a dream at the age of 7. She makes a dream, and supernaturally God fulfills that dream at the age of 24. This morning we said, God has given us a greatest gift, and the greatest gift is imagination. Close your eyes, my friend. Talk to the Lord. The greatest gift that God has given you, my friend, is imagination. What kind of imaginations do you have? A godly imaginations? And if you don't have, make it now. Make it now. Write today's date. Write it in your Bible. Write it in your book. And say, "Lord, this is my dream. From today, I will labor day and night to study your word, meditate your word, die to myself, die to my flesh, die to every other desire that is not of your kingdom, and obey your word." And my friend, when you do that, you will experience God's glory. Make a prayer for everybody, sister. Close your eyes. Make a prayer for all these children. Just as God anointed you and gave you success, pray for these children that they will also be committed to God. Just as you said, "My strength is in Jesus," I would pray to Jesus from the book of Jeremiah. Even from childhood, you began to pray. You began to meditate on the word. Pray for these children that in the future they are the ones who are going to shake the nations. They are the ones who are going to preach the gospel. They are the ones who are going to be witnesses wherever they go. True Christians who live by the word, who are doers of the word. They are not the hearers, but the doers of the word. Take that prayer.
Lord Jesus, You lifted me from poor to high level. Lord Jesus, here we pray for this all children. Who are studying seminary for priests. Please anoint them. Please give them strength to study well. And to preach gospel to every human beings. Please anoint them as anoint as Samuel. Please help us to prepare well to preach gospel in every world. In the name of Jesus, we pray to you, Lord. Amen. அதிகமாக தருபவரே.